Hi, I am Dr. Nischal, practicing as a consultant dermatologist at Nirmal Skin and Hair Clinic, Vijayanagar, Bengaluru. The smell which happens even after a shower is mainly because of the glandular activity. We have various types of glands, and among them, apocrine glands are one glands which are not actually very active and they are very rudimentary. However, as a variation, some individuals have prominent apocrine glands, and naturally these secretions from these glands, they give you a little bit of an odor. Second aspect to the smell is the bacterial action on the sweat. So whenever there is excessive sweating, and in some individuals, the bacteria acts on the sweat and they degrade into products which give you smell. So in these situations, the smell can be there in spite of bath. Third aspect is there are some metabolic disorders where some products are not completely metabolized in the body before they are being thrown out. And many metabolites in the body are also excreted through the sweat. So when these incompletely metabolized products are excreted through the sweat, then it gives you body odor. So whenever there is body odor, one, check for any family history, because many a times these genetic disorders may run in family. So in that situation, you need a complete workup with a genetic counseling. If it is a smell which happens on and off, especially in summer it is happening, then it is probably because of the sweat, and sweat can be effectively reduced. So one simple thing is take bath daily 2 times, so that you reduce the sweat and bacterial load on the skin. Wear cotton clothes, and you can use some solutions which reduce the sweat, and some solutions like a clindamycin solution to reduce the bacterial load. By doing that, you will reduce the bacterial growth is happening because of excessive sweat. When you take bath daily 2 times, whatever apocrine secretion which is accumulated, that also starts coming down. Beyond that, any smell which is not coming under control needs a workup to check for any genetic metabolic disorders.